Welcome to Powerful Women Revealed. I'm your host, Nicole Perry, and my guest today is Dr. Melanie Rabini, owner of Rabini Dental in Plymouth, Massachusetts. Dr. Rabini has been my personal and family dentist for many years, so I'm thrilled to support her in her mission to provide exceptional dentistry services to the South Shore. So without further ado, here is another Powerful Woman Revealed.
Recording. Don't say anything you don't want your mother to hear at this point. Okay. Hi, we're good. We're ready to go.
Good afternoon.
Sorry, what'd you say?
You didn't test our microphones.
Oh, okay.
You just like, oh no, my God, he's like jumped right to it.
I was testing your microphones as you were talking, actually.
Oh, okay. Oh, all right. Yeah. I was just a little, I wasn't prepared for that.
No, no problem.
You want to know what they do? Whenever I have a guest that's nervous,
yeah,
Kevin will play music.
Oh.
And then, like, one time I had Donna Fernandes with William Ravis Reels, and he played, Donna. And then my friend Amy, there's an Amy song.
Oh, yes.
So that was really cool.
Okay.
That was really nice.
Okay.
Yeah. If you want to pick up on that.
And all right.
I don't know if there's a Melanie song. I
don't think we have a Melanie song.
No, but don't worry. Don't worry about playing the music. But when I sort of give him the heads up that my guest is nervous, he usually does that, and it breaks the ice, and it's really nice. And Kathy usually gives me so that's their, that's what they usually do.
All right. Sounds good. So our
volumes are good.
Nicole's volume is good.
Okay.
Now.
And you really want to be as close to the.
Okay, sure.
Like mine's going to keep dropping.
Yeah, just tell me what to do. Yeah.
All right.
Mine is just, it's because I'm at the end.
You both sound wonderful.
Okay, good.
All right.
Because I'm not going to be as close because I'm kind of like way down here at the corner. So am I good right now?
Yeah, you're good right now.
Okay, because otherwise the microphone's in my face.
Sure, no problem. I can control that. All right, so we ready to have fun?
I'm ready.
Okay, all right.
Here we go. So excited.
All right, here we go.
Good afternoon, and welcome to WATD's Powerful Women Revealed. You're invited to enjoy an ongoing series of uplifting, educational, and intimate discussions with local powerful women that have all made the commitment to take their businesses and organizations to a higher level. These entrepreneurs have turned their dreams into reality. They work hard, outshine, and they mean business. These women reveal and share their inspirations, milestones, and successes with your host, Nicole Perry.
Good afternoon and welcome to Powerful Women Revealed. I'm your host, Nicole Perry, and today I'm so excited. We are talking about health and wellness, which we do quite often, but today very specifically about our teeth. I have a dentist here today, and I'm so excited because she's been my dentist for years. So I'm so excited to have you here and promote you. She specializes in cosmetic and family dentistry in Plymouth, Mass. Melanie Rabini has over 15 years experience as a practicing dentist and over 5 years in her own practice. She recently moved her office and is now in her new permanent location. Best location ever. If anyone knows the industrial park, it's that four-stop sign because my kids go to Rising Tide. So it's that four-stop sign, and it's that brick building right there, 45 Resnick.
That is it.
So anyway, she's my personal dentist, and I'm thrilled to have her here today. Doctor, are you doctor?
I am. Thank you very much. I'm so glad to be here. Thank you for inviting me.
Dr. Melanie Rabini, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
I'm thrilled to have you. I'm so excited. I have so many questions that I want to ask you, and they're fun questions and good questions. So I hope people are going to really stay with us today and listen. You have had your practice for over 5 years. Where are you originally from? Because I know you came from New Hampshire.
I am originally from St. Paul, Minnesota. So I grew up in Minnesota.
And that's why you went to school.
And that's why I went to school at the University of Minnesota.
Which is, wait a minute, what is Creighton University?
Creighton University is in Omaha, Nebraska. That's where I did my undergrad, and I got my degree in math.
So
after that, I went on to dental school at the University of Minnesota. Okay. I met my husband in college, and he is from the East Coast, so that's what brought us to New Hampshire and Massachusetts.
Oh, so is his family mostly in New Hampshire?
His family is South Shore, at Cape.
Oh.
Cape Cod and Martha's Vineyard.
Okay, and now, so your family's Minnesota?
My family, I come from a large family, so they're kind of spread out all over, but most of them are in the Midwest, yes.
Really? So do you feel like this is home?
I do feel like this is home now. I mean, we do travel back and forth quite a bit. In fact, after I finished dental school, my husband got a great job offer in Boston, and I thought, oh, let's try that. We'll move back at some point. So that's when I started working in New Hampshire. I had a wonderful job. I worked in a big group practice up there, and I learned a lot, and I just loved my job up there. But I kind of always wanted to have my own practice.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And so a few years ago, I started looking around, and we chose the South Shore just to be closer to family. We were spending a lot of time driving back and forth on the weekends.
So it's perfect midpoint between New Hampshire and, you know, Provincetown, actually, right?
Yeah.
If you go all the way down to the end.
Exactly. So my in-laws live in Eastham, brother and sister-in-law in Martha's Vineyard. So
nice.
Plymouth is a perfect location for the practice, yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
And you have four children.
I do have four children.
So you are really a family dentistry office. You focus on family.
We are a family and cosmetic dentistry, but we see patients of all ages. I mean, our youngest patient is one, and my oldest patient is 97.
Wow.
And we treat all patients. I so enjoy treating the whole family and getting to know the families and seeing them grow and seeing what I can do to help them improve their smile.
And keep those teeth until
keep them. Yes, exactly.
Until we're 97.
Yes, yes.
Because a lot of people are living beyond 100. And trying to explain to my children, I mean, kids don't like to brush their teeth.
No, they don't. They do not.
And mine are no different. No. And maybe yours are no different.
They don't. They're still telling me they brushed them when they didn't.
Yep. And I can spot it just like that. I'm like, no, you didn't. Go back.
Start again.
This morning, so I told you I floss and drive now. And I mentioned that to you the last time we were talking. And I handed the little doodads to the kids in the back seat. And I said, you guys really need to floss. Because I'll, you know, obviously I'm interviewing you. We're talking about dentistry at home, and I'm like, you guys need to floss. And I go, all right, well, you're not going to like this. I said to Duke, I said, well, you have your baby teeth, so we don't really care about those. I know that's really bad, right?
But you
I know. I know that you do, but I'm like, Greenlee, you have almost all of your adult teeth. Yours need to last until you're 100 or beyond. So I'm like, you need to floss. And then I'm like, well, Duke, you really need to floss too.
I have plenty of flossers. You can have them, as many as you want.
Well, I am kind of a really, you know, I have no patience. So to floss standing in the mirror like my husband does, mm-hmm. he flosses regularly every day. And I just have no patience. I'm like, I don't have time for that. I don't have time for that. So I have been flossing in the car. So I floss at the stop signs. I floss at the bus stop. I floss while I'm driving.
And that's great. I mean, we do tell all our patients, you know, regular floss is best, but those little flossers have made flossers out of people who would never floss.
That's right.
Ever.
So that's
right. A thousand times better than not flossing.
And what I recognized is the little picks are not as good. They don't work as the same as the, because there's a pick on the other side.
Right.
So you really have to use the floss side.
Yeah. So you want to floss all the way up and pull the food and the bacteria and everything out from in between your teeth. So the floss is really the only thing that cleans in between your teeth. The brush will clean everywhere else.
Yes. So. Yes. Okay. All right. Well,
so if there's one thing you want to do to kind of stay out of my chair would be...
I know. Yeah. I know. But you wouldn't have a practice if nobody flossed. I mean, if we all were flossing, you wouldn't, right? You would still have a practice.
I think I would...
Right? Okay. Let's talk about your associations. You belong to several associations, the American Dental Association, the Massachusetts Dental Society, and the South Shore District Dental Society.
So yes, I'm a member of all of those, and then I'm also a member of the Shamrock Study Club, which is probably the one I enjoy the most.
I deleted that one because I thought it was a book club.
No, that's my most, the one I look forward to the most. It's South Shore Dentists and Specialists get together once a month, and we do our continuing ed right here in Plymouth. So
it said study club, and yeah. I thought, oh, that must just be a book club.
And it's not actually. That one is the one that we probably learn the most from. So we, I invest a lot of time in continuing education just to kind of stay on top of all the new technology, everything that's changing with dentistry, and how we can improve a patient experience.
But you have to belong to a certain amount of associations. You have to have certain credentials, right?
You do. And then you do need to have a certain number of continuing education hours per year.
Per year?
Yeah. So okay. For dentists in Massachusetts, it's 40 hours every 2 years. But I far exceed that. And you kind of do to need to...
It's almost like you want to.
You do. You want to learn about how new ways you can provide quality care, make your patients comfortable, and... dentistry has changed so much in the last 10 years. I mean, there's so much. It's so much more than just fillings. I mean, you can really make a difference. You can
and
change
obviously,
a person's smile.
Obviously, yeah. I've switched over all of my silver fillings to white so that I look younger, frankly. Yeah. But the mercury is no good. It's not good for you, and that the mercury is what's in the silver fillings, right? You don't do that anymore?
That is right. The silver fillings or amalgam fillings do have mercury in them. I mean, there hasn't really been any research that has supported that they're dangerous to have in your mouth. The white fillings or the composite fillings are, they're just a stronger material. They're a better material. Most of them release fluoride to the inside of your tooth to help prevent tooth decay.
Mm-hmm.
In addition to them looking a lot nicer, it's just a better material. So, no, I haven't done a silver filling in 15 years. So,
okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I have a few more questions. But before we go to break, why did you want to become a dentist?
I wish I had a really exciting story about why I wanted to become a dentist.
Did you always know?
When I went to college, I knew I wanted to go into health sciences. So I went to Creighton University, had medical school, dental school, pharmacy, nursing, and my older brother was there. So it seemed like a perfect spot for me.
Huh.
And so I went, I took all the prerequisites, and then I took the dental entrance exam, and I did really well. And I love my job, and I just kind of... It kind of just all fell into place.
Well, you're not the typical dentist.
Yeah.
You don't fit the typical, you know, older gentleman with gray hair and big hands. You're younger and pretty and
well, thank you.
You're like barely as big as my pinky finger. All right. Well, we're going to come right back with Dr. Melanie Rabini. I hope you'll stay with us. You can find her at 45 Resnick Road, and you can also go to rabinidental.com. I hope you stay with us. We're Powerful Women Revealed right here on 95.9 WATD.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back to Powerful Women Revealed. I'm your host, Nicole Perry, and my guest today is Dr. Melanie Rabini, and you can find her at rabinidental.com, and she's also at that awesome location, 45 Resnick Road. It's just a perfect location. The building's right there. It's easy.
Yeah, it's the big medical building up on the hill.
And you've been there for almost a year?
We've been there for a year. So we were at another location in Plymouth, and then we needed more space, and we needed to get some new equipment in there. So it was time to move. So, but this is a great location because everybody goes.
And you're on the first floor, right in the door, around the corner. Love it. Now, you didn't always want to be a dentist when you were growing up. Most little girls, I wanted to be a vet, and I actually wanted to be a mechanic. I took my bike apart, and then I got to a certain point, and I couldn't put it back together. Okay. So I'm like, I better put it back together now before I completely lose, and it's all in pieces. But you didn't always want to be a dentist. You just discovered that later on.
Later on when I was in college, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so... But I can't say enough about how much I love my job. And people always say, how do you stand to be a dentist? But there's so much more to dentistry than just, fillings and, bad memories and,
I know.
So we try to make you feel as comfortable as you are when you're at our office. We have the big headphones you can put on, bring your music. We have music. We try to get you to be relaxed and comfortable, answer all your questions.
You are the most gentle dentist. And you're... And I say this with all 100% truth and honesty because you are my dentist. And I have had bad experiences in my own life. And I've seen other people have bad experiences. When I sit in your chair, I don't worry at all. I don't feel uncomfortable. I mean, I even just make a move and you're like, are you okay? And I'm like, no, I was just moving my hand. Yeah. I'm all set. So you're very caring and very understanding how can you be so caring and understanding with every single person? You got to get people moving in and out of there. You can't.
Dentistry doesn't have to hurt. And that's big myth. I mean, we certainly won't. Have many different kinds of Novocaine. If you're somebody that doesn't get numb, doesn't stay numb, everything hurts all the time, you're nervous, you feel overwhelmed, we can address all those issues and try to make you feel comfortable. But whenever you're having something done at the dental office, it really shouldn't hurt. And if it does, you need to let them know or us know, because there's many things we can do to make you feel
I Googled more the top 10 reasons people avoid going to the dentist.
Okay.
Oh my God. Number one is the needle. And that's one of the things that freaks me out. And I'm a big girl, put on my big panties, and I look the other way and just say, don't tell me when it's coming. isn't that what I do?
It's true. And I would say, we do numb the gums first with the topical numbing gel and I would say if you close your eyes, you're not going to feel much.
Yeah,
usually
I'm
when you say you close your eyes, the first thing someone does is what they open their eyes and wonder what you're going to do to them.
Oh my God. But, well, anyway, it's all, there's many things. We're not going to list everything
because
everybody knows what is, typically they're afraid of. But I want to know, is it possible to get a certain celebrity smile? Because I actually like my 18-year-old smile.
Okay.
Didn't I bring you a picture
you
of
did,
it? And I cut it out. I actually, and put it in front of my face, and I'm like, this is what I want back.
And there's absolutely is possibility for everybody to get a celebrity smile, any smile you want. Or if you're just starting to notice as you're getting older, your teeth are getting darker, they're a little bit worn at the edges, they don't look as youthful maybe as they used to, yes, there's many options, and we can explain all those to you, depending what you want to do. Yeah.
Now,
for some people, it's a couple teeth. Maybe other people, it's two. Other people, it's many more.
See, now I know that you can, many people, I don't want to name names, there are people in my family that have had the four front ones done, and possibly even the six front ones. I'm sort of a little freaked out by that. I don't want to do them all at once because it's going to change how I look. The people in my family, they don't look like they used to.
Oh, okay.
It's beautiful smiles. They're beautiful, but it's not the way that they used to look.
Oh.
So it is beautiful, and it took getting used to, but I almost want to just go one at a time. Because I know that's probably not the best.
It doesn't always work to go one at a time. But if that's what you want, if that's how what you want it to look like, then yeah, if you want to just kind of restore your smile the way it used to be before maybe things got worn or chipped or stained,
yeah,
that we can do. Yeah.
And I've got that front tooth that is fake because, well, what do I have on my front tooth?
You just have a large filling on your front tooth.
Yeah, it's a large filling because I chipped it when I was like 10 years old. Uh-huh. And then over the years, I've replaced it and replaced it. And of course, the chip gets bigger and bigger and bigger because you have to grind it down and get rid of it. Oh, that's not a good word, right? Grind. Grind it down. That's not a good word.
So we reshape it so we can
reshaping.
Make it
there you go. Yeah. Contouring and softening.
Exactly.
Okay. Well, let's talk about sugar because sugar is the worst thing. Is there a fruit that you love if people come in and say, I eat an apple a day? Or is that just the doctor away?
No, fruit is good. The sugar that... The most common cause of tooth decay is liquid sugar. Anything, you know, if you're a...
And I've been black coffee for a couple of years now, ever since I came to you, because it was expensive to have all my teeth fixed because I was I was soaking my teeth in sugar every day.
So, yeah, it's, you know, coffee, juice, Gatorade, soda, of course. But I think a lot of people don't realize the amount of sugar in orange juice and apple juice and grape juice. So, you know, in a 16-ounce glass of juice is the same amount of sugar
as a can of
as
soda.
A soda. Yeah.
See, we
so
water our juices down too.
And that's better. And it's not bad if you have, I mean, we recommend no more than 6 to 8 ounce glass of juice a day with a meal. We generally say breakfast. Just drink it with breakfast and that's fine. It's just when you start to sip on juice, coffee, and any of the above over a long periods of time, that's when you're going to get the cavities.
So,
a lot of times people will say to me, oh, I just have one coffee a day. But if it takes you 3 hours to drink it, just think every time you take it a sip, it's just coating your teeth with sugar again.
So. And that was my situation because I was drinking coffee from the moment I woke up until like 12, 1 o'clock.
And it's the trend now. It's
and even it was decaf. I mean, half of it was decaf. So it wasn't that I was, you know, jacked on caffeine all day. But it was an all-natural stevia. So I thought, oh, it's all natural. It's a stevia extract plant. You know, this is a good thing. And you're like, it's still sweetener.
Yeah.
It's still
it's better than other things, but it's still, it's the amount of time the sugar is sitting on your teeth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Now, what is the most important, or what do you love the most about educating your clients about? Is it the sugar?
Sugar
and flossing.
Sugar.
Right? Is that it? It's a wrap. Done. End of show.
I guess we like to just inform people that and I'm sure you've heard this in the news recently, the bacteria in your mouth can contribute to a whole lot of other health problems. So heart disease, stroke, diabetes, it can contribute to all those things.
So it's not just your teeth.
It's not just your teeth.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So you just enjoy educating as well as helping.
I do, because I think if we start to, you know, we want to have a healthy mouth, healthy body, healthy smile. I mean, on your path to health and wellness, I think sometimes the dental part of it gets under, you know, it's kind of an afterthought of your overall health and wellness.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because, you know, we're always so conscious about our bodies and exercise and eating healthy. We're putting our, and, you know, nobody wants to go to the dentist.
I know. So that's what we're trying to change. Exactly. The other thing about liquids and sugar is the Gatorade, and all the sports drinks have tons of sugar in them also. So the Gatorade, it just a 16-ounce bottle of Gatorade has the same amount of sugar as a 16-ounce bottle of Mountain Dew. So although you think it's a sports drink, it does have a lot of sugar in it and causes rampant tooth decay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we really have to just pay attention and just do that once in a while.
Yeah. Especially when you're out at the soccer field with the kids and the
water,
the hockey
water.
Rinks. You see all the kids drinking the Gatorade and stuff.
And the BP-free bottles.
Uh-huh.
Put water and use the whatever those things are, BP-free. I don't know what it's called.
Yeah, you're right. Exactly.
All right. Now, one last thing before we go to break. How about bad breath and halitosis? Is that something that a lot of patients have? Is it something that you can talk to them about? Is it something you can help with advice on what to do?
So most often bad breath is caused by periodontal disease or gum disease. So if you haven't had your teeth cleaned in a long time, the plaque, food, bacteria gets stuck on your teeth, and then you can't really remove it with just regular home care with flossing and brushing. You need to have a deep cleaning done, and that's usually the cause of the bad breath. Once that's gone, the gums are healthy, then the bad breath goes away. But you should also brush your tongue when you're brushing your teeth.
Yes, brush your tongue, and then yogurt. Doesn't yogurt help?
It can help too, but just overall keeping your mouth very clean.
Oral health care. Yeah. Yeah, just go for that instead of, you know, putting a Band-Aid on it.
Yeah,
basically,
yeah,
right?
But okay. In a pinch, yeah.
Sure. In a pinch. Oh, yeah. Okay. And gum. Oh, well, we'll talk about that when we come back. All right. I hope you'll stay with us. My guest is Melanie Rabini, and you can find her at rabinidental.com, and it's R-A-B-E-N-I, which is sometimes could be confusing to people. And 45 Resnick Road. You're listening to Powerful Women Revealed right here on 95.9 WATD. I'm your host, Nicole Perry, and my guest is Dr. Melanie Rabini with Rabini Dental, and you can find her at rabinidental.com, R-A-B-E-N-I, and we were just talking about gum. Now, I know, obviously, you don't like sticky substances to be chewing on or, you know, all of those taffy and things like that, but is it okay to every now and then chew sugarless gum if you want to freshen up your breath? Is that going to ruin
Absolutely.
Your teeth?
The gum, it's fine to chew the gum. You want to make sure it's sugarless, and then you also want to make sure it is, if it has xylitol in it, that can
yes.
help prevent tooth decay.
Yeah, how does that help prevent it? X-Y-L-I-T-O-L.
That's right. Xylitol is a natural sweetener. It's found in some fruits and vegetables.
Okay.
And so the way that we get cavities from regular sugar is we eat the sugar. Bacteria loves the sugar. So bacteria... consumes the sugar and then causes an acid attack on the tooth, and that's what causes tooth decay.
Oh.
But when you eat things like, let's say, gum with xylitol in it, the bacteria doesn't like the xylitol, and so it doesn't cause the acid attack or acid breakdown on the
oh.
tooth, and then that's where you, then again, the bacteria don't reproduce, there's less bacteria, and
oh.
it also prevents the... xylitol from sticking to the teeth. So that's how it prevents tooth decay. So when you're if you are a gum chewer and you like to chew gum, just make sure it's sugarless and look for something that has xylitol in it.
And it's okay to chew it like 3 times a day.
You can chew gum, yeah, as long as you don't have a lot of jaw pain or jaw issues.
Well, there's a lot of people out there that are like major gum chewers. Like I see them chewing gum all the time. And I just do it once in a while as like a treat, you know, just because I'm starving and I have no food in my car other than a stick
a
of gum.
Stopper. Yeah, exactly.
Food stopper. Okay, now what is your biggest strength in your practice? Because I could name a bunch,
okay.
but I want to know what you feel like is your biggest strength.
I would say we have a lot to offer with our brand new facility. We have digital radiography. We have intraoral cameras to show you what your teeth look like. I can show you what I see when I'm looking in your mouth.
It's really futuristic. It's almost like a, what's it called when your whole body goes into that big cocoon?
Oh, an MR.
Well, it's not a big cocoon.
This
you're standing
is, yeah, you're
there.
You're standing in a large
thing,
X-ray
thing,
machine.
Yeah.
Yeah,
the thing like comes around and I mean, I feel very futuristic, like, you know, the Jetsons.
And also those have a lot less radiation than other
Let's talk about the radiation.
But one more thing, back to my biggest strength in our practice, all of that is wonderful, but that could not all happen with my wonderful staff. My staff and the service is what sets us apart.
Yeah, and you. It all starts with you, because it's your practice.
Yes.
And your practice was great even before you had the new location and the big George Jetson machinery. So it was really great before then. But let's talk about the radiation and the x-rays, because that freaks my husband out a little bit.
Yeah.
He is like, he doesn't get it. He gets it. He has his own mindset and his own knowledge. And you can tell him that, what, it's you being 1 hour in the sun or something? What is your...
Well, dental x-rays, the question about radiation and exposure comes up all the time. But as far as dental x-rays, the radiation is so small compared to other x-rays. And then we have the digital x-rays. So that's the x-rays that show up on your computer screen immediately.
Okay.
And that is even 70% less radiation than traditional dental x-rays. So,
okay. And it equates to how long in the sun?
We recommend a full mouth series of x-rays once mm-hmm. every 5 years.
Yep.
And that equates to 2 days in the just natural environment out in the sun. Or the x-rays for bite wing x-rays that are yep. taken once a year, that equates to about 4 to 5 hours in the sun. So the benefits of x-rays far exceed
yeah.
the risks.
So, because you're seeing all the gray spots and gray areas that you can't see just by looking.
We can see so much more on an x-ray than we can by looking in your mouth. So it will check for the early onset of cavities in between the teeth. It'll check for the health of the bone. It checks for, position of unerupted teeth or wisdom teeth, bone loss.
Now, you brought up wisdom teeth. Yeah. I have my own theory on wisdom teeth.
Okay.
I, had, when I was 16, I had one of my molars was probably black. I don't even know. I mean, I had like a temporary filling that was there for like 3 years.
Oh, okay.
It was really bad. You know, situation with the parents, whatever. It is what it is. So I chose to just have it pulled.
Okay.
Because I knew that my parents at the time couldn't afford to do whatever, put a crown or do whatever really needed to be done. So I said, just yank it, $50, yank it. My wisdom tooth moved into that spot. But that doesn't necessarily always happen. If someone loses a tooth, it might not necessarily move in that. Well, mine is kind of like perfect. It like slid right in and it's side by side.
That's unusual that would happen. It does happen, but not very common. But, you know what? We can tell with x-rays the position of the wisdom teeth, if they're laying sideways or if they're incorrect position, and there is a possibility of them moving into the mouth, then we wouldn't recommend extracting them. But in situations where we know there's no room in the mouth for them to erupt or they're laying sideways, it's just...
If they're laying sideways, that's not good. No. It's going to push against the other.
Right, you may end up damaging another tooth.
So usually, like my husband, I think he had his wisdom teeth taken out when he was a teenager. So generally, that's what you kind of like to do.
We do.
Why as a teen? Because I had my other three extracted when I was in my 30s.
Okay. Yeah. Generally, they're easier to extract in a younger person. A lot of times, the roots aren't completely developed, so it makes the extraction a little easier, or much easier. And younger people just can tolerate surgery in general better, heal faster. But I would say the number one reason is just because oftentimes the tooth isn't completely developed, and we already know it's not going to be able to move into the mouth in a good position, so it's much easier to take out in a younger person.
All right. Now, what do your clients say about you? You know what? Actually, I saw a few comments, testimonials on your website.
Yeah.
I don't think they do you justice. They're very lovely comments, but I don't think they do it justice.
I would say the most often my patients will say that I listen to them. I listen to, what the problem, what their issues are with their teeth, what they really don't like about their teeth, and what they want to do to fix them.
You don't do a lot of talking. Because Reese was just there, and you don't do a lot of talking, and we're talking about we were kind of having a parent teenager discussion right in front of you, and then you're sort of listening and really just giving the best example and the best advice.
Exactly. So that's what I try to do. And, we try to provide the care that the patient wants. Not everybody wants, a whole lot of dental care if they just can't. We want to, of course, restore their mouth to a healthy mouth.
And as close to what it looked like originally.
Exactly. Right.
So that you don't really change the way that, the whole look. Okay.
Yes.
All right. Well, we've got one more segment. I hope you'll stay with us with Dr. Melanie Rabini, and you can find her at rabinidental.com. It's R-A-B-E-N-I. You're listening to Powerful Women Revealed right here on 95.9 WATD. Your host, Nicole Perry, and my guest is Melanie Rabini with rabinidental.com. We haven't touched on cosmetic dentistry yet. You focus in general family care and then also cosmetic dentistry. And that was one of the reasons why I contacted you way back when, several years ago, when you were over by the Walgreens at Exit 6.
We used to be on Somerset Street, yes.
Yeah. Because I've got the front tooth,
yeah,
that is now brown, that I try to whiten as much as I can until I can get it fixed.
I would say most often people need a combination of both. So we do comprehensive dental care. We provide many services from, white fillings to tooth whitening. We do Invisalign to straighten your teeth.
Mm. So Invisalign, so you don't do braces, but Invisalign is...
I don't do traditional braces, right? Mm-hmm. Invisalign is moving your teeth without braces. I'm sure you've seen those commercials on TV. So you just wear a series of clear plastic trays and they'll move your teeth in back into position or move them where
we
want
them to. How long does that take?
It all depends on the patient
and obviously
how much movement needs to be done. But for most of the patients we treat with Invisalign, it's minor movements of the front, top, and bottom front teeth to get things in position to either restore with crowns or fillings or things like that. Or, maybe they had braces many, many years ago and the teeth have shifted back. We can push them back into place.
Oh, well, I've heard that happens sometimes after pregnancy.
That your teeth move?
Yeah. Is that true?
All the things they don't tell you about.
All the things they don't tell you about becoming a mother?
Exactly. Your teeth are always moving, and if you had braces in the past and you didn't continue to wear your retainers forever, your teeth will move back. Even if you had braces 20 years ago, your teeth are still going to shift. And as you get older, teeth tend to shift more towards the midline, so everything kind of shifts. And people often notice crowding on the lower front teeth.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
And then they're also going to shift if you don't have your wisdom teeth removed, right?
That can cause pressure on the back teeth.
And does it help with sinuses when you have your wisdom teeth extracted? Because it's not just your teeth. It's all your ear, nose, throat. Like, it's all connected.
It is all connected, yes.
So they all kind of affect each other.
So if you ever have an infection in your mouth or a tooth, it's not safe to have an infection in the bone in your mouth because it is all connected.
Yeah. Wow. And you know, when I had my teeth extracted, I had that dry socket. Oh my God.
Oh, that happens every
day. Oh, that was awful. It was awful. But I also had a child that fell down the stairs when he was 2, and his front teeth went right through his lip. Not the lip, but below the lip. And they couldn't put stitches because it would get infected. Like, I don't know, the mouth. You have to really be careful
you
about.
You do need to really be careful. The mouth heals really fast, too. So it depends. Oh. It all depends on the child and the situation. But a lot of times, yeah, they don't need stitches.
Mm. Now, what about, you know, this wasn't on the list to talk about.
That's okay.
But I just thought of it. What about the people that have the piercings?
That, we see a lot of damage to teeth with tongue piercings, yeah.
Why?
So they'll break teeth. Because, I mean, we try to encourage people to take them out, but if you have to have one,
but if it's in the center of your tongue, how is that even going anywhere near your teeth? Well, you move your tongue around.
Often the metal ball on the end will hit the teeth and break the teeth. We've restored a lot of teeth that have been broken by those things, but your risk of infection of your tongue is very high with piercing, so...
So better to get a piercing on the lip than it is on the tongue?
Yes.
No. Yes?
I would say lip than tongue, yes. But
go get tattoos. Just don't
do
any piercings.
Else. Yeah.
Go get tattoos. Don't get any piercings at all or put it in your belly button. Yeah. That's all I have to say.
Usually
about
after
that.
Somebody breaks a tooth with it, then they take them out. It's kind of...
Oh, because they realize that this is a bad...
But it's the risk of infection that is almost
is
worse
the highest.
Than breaking a tooth. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. So within cosmetic dentistry, Invisalign is part of what you do.
Right. If your teeth need to be straightened or moved, slight movements or maybe even more drastic movements, you know, we can sit down and see if you're a good candidate for the Invisalign. But we've had great results with that.
And the average person generally wears it for 6 months to a year and a half. It's all in that realm.
Yeah, it really depends how much movement of your teeth needs to be done. But I would say anywhere from 12 to... Six or you know
12 to 18.
Minor movements, 6 to 12, a little bit more movements, 12 to 18. Yeah.
Okay.
But
all right.
People are much more compliant because you can't see them. They're willing to do it, and if you wear the trays, they really do. It really works well.
Yeah. Okay. All right. And now we're almost out of time. We do have a little couple of more minutes, right? Okay. What would you encourage parents? All right, so we're encouraging individuals to floss and take care of their teeth and their health and brushing and brush the tongue and all of that. What is a good thing to tell parents?
Pay really close attention to your children's diet. I mean, a lot of times we have more control over the diet than we do of how well they're brushing their teeth. But, you know, you want a low-sugar diet and really try to instill in them the good habits early on when they're really young. I mean, with young children, if you start flossing their teeth, you know, it just kind of becomes a part of the routine.
Part of the habit.
Yeah.
I know.
So as soon as they have baby teeth in the back and you can get in there and clean in between them with floss.
And start doing it. And it's better to floss and brush your teeth that night before you go to bed, because when you go to bed, all of that junk is just sitting on your teeth while you're sleeping.
I mean, we recommend brushing twice a day and flossing at least once a day, and at night is most important, and that's the exact reason, just because everything you've eaten all day is now sitting in between your teeth while you're sleeping.
Yes, exactly, and that's not good.
Yeah, so we say after breakfast, and then last thing you do before you go to bed at night.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so what we discovered when we were in the office last week is that, you know, you're like, so what do you eat on a regular basis? And Reese is like, well, and I just filled it in. I'm like, okay, cereal, cookies, bagels, cereal, more cereal for snacks, cereal for dinner, cereal for breakfast. He is
so
a cereal.
It's the sugary cereal.
Guess what he did?
Uh-oh.
He, when they went to the store, he researched all the cereal boxes and looked for low sugar cereals that he could still enjoy.
Okay.
Isn't that nice?
Oh, good. I'm glad he was listening.
He was listening, and he cares, because he realizes it's not only that you're saving your teeth, but you're saving money.
Yeah.
when you take care of your teeth.
I mean, certainly not teenagers, but people, they underestimate how
effective it can be when you do take care of them.
That is right.
Like, you're saving
really
money. It's a preventative.
The quality of life. If you lose your teeth and you have broken teeth and
It's preventative.
It's preventative.
That's the bottom line. All right. Well, we are out of time today. I want to thank you so much for being here.
I so enjoyed it. Thank you for having me.
I'm telling you. I told you it was a conversation over coffee.
That's what you said. Exactly.
And usually I put myself in your hands, and today wait a minute. Did I say that right? Usually I'm in your hands, but today you were in my hands.
Yeah.
So there we go. That's what I meant to say. All right. Well, I want to thank you so much for listening and recognizing all of these powerful women right along with me. You can find Melanie Rabini at rabinidental.com, also at 45 Resnick Road, right over in the industrial park in Plymouth. To find all the powerful gals info, you can go to powerfulwomenrevealed.com and also on YouTube. I hope you will tune in next Sunday after the news at noon. I'm your host, Nicole Perry. Have a great week. And remember, knowledge is power.
I want to thank you so much for watching Powerful Women Revealed. Knowledge is powerful, and it is my personal mission to connect powerful women to you in a fun, entertaining, and educational way. 8 out of 10 entrepreneurs are women, and there are so many women entrepreneurs that deserve to be recognized for their expertise and passion. Melanie does not have the appearance of the stereotypical dentist, and she is truly dedicated to serving her community by educating her clients and giving them the best smiles they can possibly have. I consciously surround myself with very smart and powerful women like Melanie because I truly learn so much from them. Her commitment to giving the utmost gentle care, accompanied by her passion to educate, is beyond what anyone could hope for in a family dentist. I am so grateful for discovering Dr. Rabini several years ago, and I am grateful to have her and her staff looking out for me and my family and truly having our best interests at heart. I am very proud to promote Melanie and her practice. I absolutely thrive on shining a great big magnifying glass on women such as Dr. Rabini and how they are helping people in and beyond our communities. Powerful Women Revealed is about strengthening who we are together, empowering women of all ages to follow their dreams, and bringing a spark of inspiration to the entrepreneurial career women of our future. I hope you will tune in next time. Until then, I'm your host, Nicole Perry, and I want to thank you for watching Powerful Women Revealed.